Hello, my nakamatachi, this is JoyGirl, and we are going to discuss the future bounties for the Straw Hats. I've been getting a lot of requests to do a Straw Hats bounties video in the comments section for a while now, and whilst not usually the type of topic I would cover, mostly because it's a discussion that I've seen, well, discussed by a number of other content creators. Seriously, I've seen a lot of these in my YouTube recommendations, but I've decided to get amongst it and now I will take on the request and have fun predicting the next bounties for the Straw Hat crew after Wano. I will, however, have to warn anime-only fans that this will discuss recent manga content, so please note, you have been warned. Before we begin our fun little bounty predictions though, I will have to take a quick time to ask for a short amount of your time to please drop a like on this video and also to subscribe for more One Piece discussions. Now this list is purely speculations of course, and you may find that these numbers don't align with what you would assign, so if you don't agree with these numbers and you'd like to share your frustrations, then you can do so by leaving a comment below on what you think the new Straw Hats bounties will be. And now, let's get into it. The spotlight that the Straw Hats have been getting in Wano in comparison to other post-timeskip arcs has led to speculations that there will be huge increases in bounties, and whilst I also believe that there will be significant increases for our crew, especially considering the presence of CP0 on Onigashima, who will be privy to most of the events which take place in the arc, I don't believe that it will be as astronomical as you would expect. Well, not as astronomical as Luffy getting a 5.656 billion berries, which I expect to be his very final bounty. Partly because I don't think these post-Wano bounties will be the final bounties for the Straw Hats, and I think the huge increase that we'll see is once they become the biggest threat to the world government, which is something that I see happening once the Straw Hats become allied with the Giants, which I believe will happen after Elbaf. But we're not here to talk about Elbaf, and that's another discussion altogether, so enough with the chit-chat because you are here for berries. Starting with Chopper. Chopper's bounties so far have been assigned to him under his mistaken role as the crew's pet. Being a much bigger threat than his current 100 berry bounty suggests, Chopper suffers from the lack of recognition due to some misunderstanding. As for whether this will change post-Wano, Chopper so far doesn't seem to have a clear matchup. After having a brief fight with Queen, Chopper is now moving on to assisting Zoro. However, what Chopper has done so far is to assist by helping everyone Queen infected with the virus, and during this time Chopper helped them, he was in his normal form, which is the form the world government recognized as the Straw Hat's pet and thus the cause of the undervaluation of his bounty. So should the world government witness Chopper and the threat that is his monster point, then any misunderstanding will dissolve. Unfortunately though, I don't see this misunderstanding changing anytime soon as I believe Chopper's bounty will remain a running gag in the series, but just for the fun of it, Chopper's bounty will have the huge increase, percentage-wise at least, of 100%, which will bring the Straw Hat Doctor's bounty from 100 to a whopping 200 berries. Next up is Nami. Nami's current bounty is 66 million berries, and much like her previous bounty, Nami again has the best photograph for her bounty poster, which is a trend that I believe will continue no matter how many times the amount of her bounties change until the end of the series. As for the amount itself, fresh from her win against Ulti, Nami is running around Onigashima right now, serving as one of Tama's primary protectors, which could result in more run-ins and developments, which could potentially contribute to her bounty increase. But even if she doesn't get into any more significant fights, I believe Nami's bounty will have a significant increase to her dismay due to her participation in the war and the defeat of Ulti, one of Kaido's top officers. So, an increase of 200 million will be added to Nami's current bounty, pushing the Straw Hat Navigator's total bounty to a sweet 266 million berries. Moving on to Brook. Brook's bounty was raised to 83 million berries after the events of Dressrosa, which surprisingly did not see an increase following his involvement in Whole Cake Island, where he was arguably the MVP, stealing a copy of the Pornoglyph in Big Mom's possession. Currently, Brook isn't engaged in a one-on-one fight with any of Kaido's top officers because Robin is set to take on Black Maria, and Brook instead is looking like he will take on Black Maria's underlings, which albeit could of course change should Brook direct his attention to another prominent participant in the Onigashima raid. Since Wano is looking like a Straw Hat centered arc, I believe that even if Brook doesn't end up fighting one of Kaido's top officers, he will be involved in something significant, and even for simply being a member of the Straw Hats, as well as the fact that he is due for a double increase considering the events of Whole Cake Island, Brook's bounty will see an increase of 250 million berries, yo-ho-ho-ing the musician's total bounty to 333 million berries. Next, Franky. The only Straw Hat involved in taking down the Don Quixote pirates back in Dressrosa, whose bounty didn't rise above 100 million berries, causing our cyborg to be upset, I do believe we will be seeing his wish come true, where his involvement in this war will see a huge increase in Franky's bounty. This is already indicated by Franky taking on a top Beast Pirates officer in the Tobiroppo member Sasaki, not to mention his early highlights in running over Big Mom with his Black Rhino. And if we get to see more of Franky's post-time skip weapons or abilities like I've been saying, then I do believe his bounty will rise accordingly, resulting in the shipwright to have a massive 354 million berries placed on his head, though whether this number still being under 500 million berries will continue to cause frustration is to be seen. Moving on to Robin. Robin's relatively low bounty is the cause of much confusion. Her original 79 million berries was assigned under the pretext of the 8-year-old sinking 6 Buster Call battleships, with the real threat she poses as the sole Ohara survivor able to decipher the poneglyphs not disclosed publicly. If we were to assess her true threat, being the only known living individual able to read the poneglyphs, and being a member of the Straw Hat Pirates who edge ever closer to finding the One Piece, Robin's true bounty would be one that rivals some of the world's most dangerous criminals. However, since joining Luffy and the crew, she's only received minor increases, which has been given only for being part of the Straw Hat's exploits and her true threat still understated, which I can only explain as the world government not wanting other strong pirates and factions to become aware of Robin and her most dangerous ability. And because of this, I believe the world government will raise Robin's bounty following Wano, but for similar reasons, it will only be stated to be due to her involvement in taking down the Beast Pirates and being a part of the Straw Hats, still concealing her true threat. Though the number itself will have a sizable increase, raising the Archaeologist's bounty to 330 million berries. Assigning this amount for Robin could result in a fun situation where Sanji could try to bond with Robin over having the same bounty before he realizes the update of his own bounty, and Robin sharing the same number as Sanji's former bounty could have a great foreshadowing where we saw Robin replace Sanji in the fight against Black Maria, representing her not only taking Sanji's place in that battle, but also his bounty. Next up, Usopp. Usopp's current and previous bounties have served as great comedy, with Usopp being another victim, or beneficiary, however you want to look at it, to the world government's misunderstandings, first being released under Soga King and then God Usopp. Usually we see Usopp building up his own persona to fool others, which isn't something that we've seen so far at Wano, but I think we could still have him being recognized as a legend at Wano. Whilst he currently doesn't seem to have a clear matchup of his own, I believe Usopp will have a hand in Orochi's downfall since Page 1 was taken care of by Big Mom, which will result in Wano becoming free from Orochi. A fun idea is if Usopp could be the one to deliver the final blow to Orochi, all taking place under the crescent moon, and this is the scene that the Wano citizens witness, culminating in the belief of Usopp as Wano's savior in their minds, giving Usopp the title of something like Shogun Slayer or the Serpent Slayer, or maybe even the Dragon Slayer, becoming source to even more confusion and hilarity, with some even thinking that this epithet refers to Kaido. But even if this doesn't happen with Orochi, Usopp can still have some mistaken identity if he tag teams with Tama in feeding her Dango to even more Beast Pirates using his sniper skills, and this is all credited to Usopp instead. In any case, I believe we will be seeing the Straw Hat Sniper receive a ridiculously high bounty of 500 million berries under a similarly ridiculous name. Going on to Jinbei. Jinbei currently holds the second highest bounty within the Straw Hats at 438 million berries, which was an amount assigned after Marineford due to him being a former warlord of the sea who refused to fight with the world government and instead broke out of Impel Down and helped Luffy and the Whitebeard pirates, tendering his resignation from the Shichibukai. His current matchup against Who's Who may mean that he doesn't have an exponential increase due to the world government being grateful for him defeating the ex-CP9 agent. However, his seemingly easy handling of Who's Who suggests that he still has more left in the tank, which could come into use in further involvement in future battles, which could contribute to his bounty increase. And considering his reputation and title as former Warlord of the Sea, who has officially joined the forces of an increasingly powerful and influential threat in Luffy's Straw Hats, he will see an increase of 322 million berries, pushing the total amount of the new Straw Hats Helmsman to 760 million berries, which is an extra zero from his initial 76 million berry bounty from when he was a part of Fisher Tiger's Sun Pirates. And now, our monster trio, Sanji. Sanji is another one of our Straw Hat members whose bounties have been used for comedic effect. His latest bounty now reflects his family name, much to his distaste due to the use of the Vinsmoke name, albeit simultaneously to his satisfaction, as his bounty was now again higher than that of Zoro's. Sanji's new bounty is one of the trickiest to assign because a part of me thinks that Sanji may not even have an increase, or at least a substantial one, due to the potential of his bigger achievements occurring whilst using his Raid Suit's ability to turn him invisible, and so Sanji will not be recognized, resulting in only a minor increase solely for being a part of the Straw Hats, which would be funny in its own right. If Sanji's bounty isn't increased after Wano, then this also gives us the potential for a future scenario where Sanji's fourth bounty later on will again be higher than the fourth bounty that Zoro receives after Wano, which is a trend we've seen for each of their past respective bounties. On the other hand, Sanji defeating Queen, a commander with a bounty over 1.3 billion berries, and whatever stealthy accomplishments we'll see during the war, it seems appropriate to give Sanji an increase worthy of being one of the Straw Hat's powerful combatants, resulting in the cook's new bounty to skyrocket to 1.2 billion berries. Because 1 plus 2 equals sun. Of course, the comedy with Sanji's bounty photo would still continue though, with Sanji's new bounty released under his stealth black persona, associating him to Germa 66, again causing Sanji much frustration in the process. Next up, Zoro. Similar to the situation between Zoro and Sanji, Zoro's first three bounties were always higher than Luffy's first three, with Zoro's current bounty sitting at 320 million berries. Though Luffy has since had further increases now at his sixth bounty, whilst Zoro's not having increased since his participation in bringing down the Don Quixote pirates at Dressrosa, if we are going to see the trend of Zoro surpassing Luffy's bounty return, then I don't see a more perfect situation than here at Wano. Zoro has arguably had one of the most impressive showings at Wano so far, being able to take the combined attack of two of the Yonko, as well as being only the second individual to be able to leave a scar on Kaido, and now with Sanji fighting Queen, I'm almost certain that we'll see Zoro taking on the Beast Pirate's top officer in King, whose bounty is most likely to be the highest of the Beast Pirates outside the Governor General himself. These impressive feats will raise the Swordsman's bounty to a respectable 1.7 billion berries, fitting that of a First Commander's bounty, and one only second to that of his captain. Which brings us to Luffy. Luffy leading a pirate crew that is getting progressively closer to the One Piece, and his influence, which only increases with each island he lands on, is something that the world government has already recognized, as evident through the massive 1.5 billion berry bounty, which has even caused Big News Morgans to grant him the honorary title of being one of the Yonko. This will only continue after the events of Wano, and if Luffy's eventual defeat of Kaido, the strongest creature in the world, is publicized, such news is sure to shake the entire world of One Piece to its core. Luffy's reputation as the individual who led the victory against the combined forces of two of the Yonko, considered to be the most powerful pirates in the world, will be a monumental achievement that will result in the world government assigning a bounty worthy of such a feat. Which is why I think the Straw Hat Captain will receive a bounty of 3.5 billion berries, more than doubling his current amount. And this will also be higher than Blackbeard's current bounty, but I believe that Blackbeard's current actions, which we have yet to hear updates on, will result in a bounty even higher than Luffy's new bounty by the time of their inevitable meeting. This will continue the trend of Luffy being the underdog in fights, not only because of Blackbeard's seemingly powerful ability of having multiple devil fruits, but also in terms of how much of a threat they are considered to be by the world government. But what are your thoughts? Please let me know in the comments below. Please like the video and don't forget to subscribe if you wish to see more increasing amounts of One Piece discussions. Thank you to our patrons who help support this channel. This is JoyGirl, and I'll see you again soon.